Let's balance the equation for C14H30 plus O2. We'll also take a look at the type of reaction. So let's count the atoms up on each side. We do that, we get... And the only thing to really be careful about here is we have two oxygens here and the one here. So we have three oxygens here in the product side. With combustion reactions, it's best to leave the oxygen here till last, because when we change this coefficient, it won't change the number of carbons or hydrogens. So oxygen goes last. Why don't we just put 14 carbons? We have 1 times 14, and we need to update the oxygens. Now we have 14 times 2, that's 28, plus the 1 oxygen in water, 29. Let's fix the hydrogens. We could just put a 15 right here, because 2 times 15, that gives us 30. They're fixed. Let's update the oxygens again. 2 times 14 is 28, plus 15 times the 1, that gives us... So now we have a bit of a problem. We have 2 oxygens here, and then 43 on this side. The way to do this is to think 2 times some number. That equals 43. 2 times 43 over 2, that equals 43. The 2s would cancel out. So we could put 43 over 2 as our coefficient. And this equation is balanced. These are the correct coefficients. Some teachers, they don't like to have these fractions, but we can fix that pretty easily. Let's just multiply everything by 2, and then we get 2, 43, 2, 30 as our coefficients. So this is also the correct ratio. If you wanted to look at the type of reaction, we have this hydrocarbon and oxygen. We get carbon dioxide and water. So the type of reaction is combustion. This is also a redox reaction as well, since the oxidation states change. This is Dr. V with the balanced equation for C14H30 plus O2. Thanks for watching.